Well, g'day, Tubes. No, I'm not filming a Farm Sim Saturday this way for you. just doing a bit of mowing, getting stuff ready for Farm Sim Saturday for Saturday. And I'm going to leave her a few more days till I start filming. So if you want to go on last week's video and vote for the baler you liked, it's pretty close between the big felled self-propelled baler and the John Deere baler. So it's pretty much neck and neck. I'm just actually mowing right now, and this is a bad spot. I don't know why. I have issues. My mower goes fluttery. Just doing a bit of mowing. This is, I think, the fourth or fifth cut I've done in this field now. And we're going to get the tedder out, and I'm going to do that next week. I'm going to get her all mowed, ready to go, and then I'll get the tedder. Probably start next week's video teddering this field, drying her all out. Then we'll get our big windrowing machine I like, get that going on the front, and put her back into a row, start baling. So go on last week's video, last week's Farm Sim Saturday. There's a link there that you can vote which baler you like the most. And you should really watch the video if you haven't, because we tested 9 different balers, and so far there's a great big self-propelled unit that it's got quite a few votes. But there's a John Deere baler that we use that's actually pretty, I think it's actually ahead now. So yeah, but anyways, then I'm gonna get this done here. I'm gonna head her down to the garage and show you the brake line work I did a bit last night on it, and then show you the new one I made. It actually come out pretty good, the doing all those bends and stuff in it. So anyways, I'll keep mowing here, almost done, another couple of passes, a nice wide mower. I love this thing, it works awesome. And really hard to find. I do have a whatchamacallit, link I guess for it. But anyways, we are going to head her down and I'll show you these brake lines. So back to this POS again. I think you all know what that means. I don't know if I can show you this too. I still got her jacked up pretty high here, but there's my new one. So I can't really show you super too much well other than what I'm doing here, but she's all bent up again the way the other one was. It's a little bit different because my bender doesn't bend it quite as tight of a dewey as these ones. It's a little more of a gradually radius, which actually is probably better. I don't know. So I haven't got it actually hooked in yet. It's got to go into here, into the port here, but I got the other end hooked up and it's all sort of, well, hard to get under here and show you, but it's all coming in, and it was a bit of a challenge to get the bends the way they had them. They were pretty tight. So I kind of cheesed and come in and did like a loop thing, and I think it should be fine. It's actually not touching anything. So I think that should be all right. Should work good. And what else was there? The other one I'm going to do, I've actually got it, I think, off now. Yes, I do. And that's the one that just runs up the rail into the front. Front left. Ugh. Look at these things, it'll get you a better shot. Well, there's the old one, the old Sprarly. So I didn't do too bad, I don't think. It was pretty good, bent up pretty good. You just gotta remember which way the bender goes to which way you want the bend. So seemed to do pretty good there. That actually sounds probably like it's still all right. Looks okay. Now if you listen to, say, this, you can tell the difference, right? It just sounds like it's gone rotten. And that is, this one was actually probably fine, but I'm like, not worrying about it. I'm replacing the whole thing. The only place, actually, this was the one, yeah, this is the one I'm working on now. So this would have gone down like this, and then there's one other piece missing that turns and goes in. I think I've got it inside. That's the line that goes up along the rail and it services the front left right there. tees in and goes in there. I've actually got it made. And it went not too bad. But yeah, this one I think is still probably fine. It just seems structurally stronger. Or these ones are just like frickin' junk, you know. Frickin' junk. But anyways, I got some better stuff. Of course, that's locked. Some better stuff for this line here. I got actually some of the, yeah, where's my key now? Great. Oh, I'll find that after. But anyways, I've got some better stuff for that one. Let me go show you here if I can. What the heck did I do with my key? Oh, there it is. Oh. I actually got some quarter inch, which I probably should use for those other ones, but I think they'll be all right. It's just the stuff from basically pretty much here back are the ones that get all the spray coming up and all the crap off the front tires and all, you know, inside of here. All the stuff gets sprayed right underneath the box and all lands on this stuff and it goes like crap. So I got actually a coil of the good stuff. That's it there. Like the copper nickel stuff. Supposed to be the best stuff available now, other than, you know, something else, but there isn't anything else except stainless steel might be better. But so I'm gonna do that, this one, redo this one all the way back, but I'm gonna actually run it up where it should be, and then 90 and then in, so that should work good. It'll be back where she should be. And it's supposed to be better stuff. That's what all the shops in town apparently are using. And we shall see by next year. But so far it's, I don't know. It's got a bit of corrosion, it looks like there. But maybe it'll last longer in the long run. I don't know. But like this is like a year and a half and it's freaking junk already. And right now I'm going to get some stuff and spray on there. But anyways, let's head her in the back. I'll show you this other line. I already got it made, but I haven't run it yet. This is the other line, and this is, so your tire would be here, so it's going to run up the frame rail, and then it kind of turns a little bit this way, and then it 90s down into the fitting. I have tried it on the truck, and then I had to, of course, you know, go back and measure, and then I got to bend this end yet whenever I get her in there. I'll probably just do hand bends, and then turn and bend, and then the fitting's on there, and everything ready to go, so that should be good. Now, this stuff's a little better. And just a straight steel line. Now it is straight steel line, but it's got this like green paint stuff on it. But you can see here where I kind of dragged her along the floor, it's already wore off. You know, so it's like really, it's not probably going to last any longer. Yeah, that's it there. And then this is the smaller stuff for the rear that I had to get there. So I don't know why they don't put the same size on everything, but anyways, whatever. So. So that should be good. The little bender here works really good. Somebody sent me this and I can't remember who it was now, but thank you very much. It works good. It does 6 mil, 8 mil, and 10 mil. I can't really focus on that, but that's what it does, and it's the 6 mil that I was using here, so this little wee tiny stuff, but it works good. Put your line through there. Actually, hang on a sec. I got some of this copper line here. I'll show you. Okay. Oh. Huh. Okay. Now you'd have to know how this thing works and pre-measure so you don't bend your stuff too far or not close enough. This one's actually a bit too far up, but it actually clears stuff nicer, so it's not going to get laying on crap and corroding again. Oh, how long? Okay, so we want to do a 90 degree bend. So what we're going to do is start it from the zero and bring it around until the zero comes actually just a little bit past the 90. So that's a 90 degree bend. Now, if you wanted to, for some reason, bring it right back on itself, you just keep going. So we bring this right around to the 180. Like that. What the heck? It's freaking raining out. Okay. So there's your, like, your perfect nice 180 bend. No kinks, no. Now, let me try to do that myself. And what's going to happen is I'm going to end up bending it and it's probably going to kink and it's not going to look that nice. Oh. Well. Yeah, you can see the kink starting there. It's kind of, well, you can't, but I can. It's starting to kink itself right there. I've pretty much got it right around, but you can tell the difference. It's so much nicer, right? So there's no kinks. As soon as you put a kink in there, you're reducing your flow like a big time. So that's definitely a nice tool. So I do thank you for who sent that to me a while back there, and definitely makes a nice bend. Couldn't have done that by hand, I don't think. You might have been able to do it around like a socket or something, but you still might have got a bit of crimp going on there. What in the frick is going out here? All of a sudden it just started raining. Really? That's kind of weird. Started raining just all of a sudden. You know, it rains all of a sudden, but okay. I guess maybe we're not going to be able to do too much of the brake stuff right now anyways. But that's okay. We'll just leave her like that. Freaking rain. I just backed her. I'd probably got it on the camera. All of a sudden, it's just like on the roof. It's like, where the heck did that come? It looks like it's just like someone just went on you and that was it. But weird. Oh, wait, never mind. Here comes some more. Well, that's a weird day. It wasn't supposed to rain today, but apparently it's raining. I know what I need to do. I gotta get my stuff back here and spray that thing on there and get it all gooey. Okay, we'll give her a good spray of move it stuff here. Because I want to move it. I'll let her sit a minute and then I'll give her some more. I'll climb underneath and do that other fitting too. Well, that stuff works pretty good. I sometimes take a little bit of time, but there's stuff in there, I guess, that actually, like, I don't know, it bites through the rusty crap. I wouldn't say it dissolves it, but it bites through enough that it actually starts, you can loosen things up really good with it. I've had pretty good luck with this stuff. Thousands of different usages. Protects all metal, loosens rust, seized parts, nuts and bolts, fast, long-lasting lubricant. Yeah, I wouldn't say that. It does kind of dry up after a while. Displaces moisture, user-friendly formulation, environmentally responsible. 100% active ingredients, non-solvent. Non-flammable as a liquid, replaces many different products, blah blah blah. I don't know, it's good stuff. It is kind of expensive, but you don't, you know, sit there and blow a whole can on something. She works good, so I think I'm out of room there, boys. Nope, not for one more, maybe. But anyways, that's my second can storage. My main one is in the garage. So I let these sit a few minutes, and then I'm not really ready to break this one off of here yet, but yeah, you can see she's kind of sleepaging in too. I was going to redo this one. This one was joined back a piece. I think I'm going to try to remake the one. Make it a whole new one right from this distribution box here. Now what they've done is it comes out of the box and it does like that 180 like we just made. And then up along this frame rail. And then down and in, which makes more sense because this is actually a longer travel, I think, than that. But it's easier now I got the box off. So, don't know if I'm going to do more work on this right now. I got that other line. I got to get them fished in and then get him hooked back up. I'm doing one at a time because I don't want to get the parts messed up. Oh, this cap's got to go back on the Dewey here. I don't want to get the port's messed up, you know, and I don't know if it really matters if which one goes into where, but I'm pretty sure it probably does. So But, man, I'm getting tired of working on this truck, let me friggin' tell ya. But, another year, if I can get a year out of it, I'll be happy. And, go from there. Like, I don't really want to scrap it yet. Mostly because the tires are still pretty good on it. So, once they get wore down enough, that'll be it, probably. I won't bother putting new tires on it. Even though I just bought a new spare, but you need a spare. That's kind of a, you know, a given. But, I mean, the tires are still pretty decent on these yet, so, you know, there's no point in spending, well, I think it was $155 for each tire when I just got this spare. So that times four, it's not worth putting that money into it, right? You might as well just get something else after. So if I can get another year out of it, that'll probably... I'll pretty much do these tires in, because you can tell. Let's roll one out. Well, these two here, for instance. This is the back left. So there's that. Woo. There's a little comparison for you. So there's, I don't know what's on these now. Fair bit. Not a whole lot of miles on them, but. So that is, oh, I can actually measure. I use my little screwdriver and I go like that to there. So that's how much tread's left. Now if I go to there, there's probably a couple millimeters burnt off of these ones. So, and they're like a full winter tire, so they don't last quite as long, you know, but I think I'll get another year to these definitely for sure. And then we'll send her down the road. We'll get rid of her, this rig anyways. And I do apologize, I did mention yesterday about the truck I was looking at with a little small snowplow on it. It had some body damage and stuff. I forgot to put the link on. I freaking knew I would too. I'm horrible with that kind of stuff, so you gotta remember that. But tonight, I will try to remember when I'm editing it. I'll open the thing and leave the page open, and then it'll remind me when I'm uploading. So that you can have a look at it if you want. I'm not super serious about it really, but it's a fairly good price, I'm thinking, but for 2008, I mean, 3 more years and it's gonna be 10 years old, then you're gonna be in the brake lines again, unless they've changed their stuff when they started building the newer ones. I don't know what to say really. I'd really like to go new and then trade in maybe every year, every 2 years for another new one. Then you don't have to worry about any of this crap, you know, basically get 2 years of the warranty, so everything will be covered, and then we won't be fighting messing around with this stupid thing anymore. It'll be one freaking thing off of my plate that I really don't really have room for on the plate, you know. So but anyways, stop raining, so I guess I'll go do a bit of mowing. I got lots of mowing to do, so not necessarily the grass so much as those friggin' stick weeds that keep growing up. Man, I don't know, like these, well, funny enough, I don't, oh, there's a couple here. These little stupid stick weed things. And they're like, they're really woody. So there's a seed part of them, I guess, I keep spreading. But if you leave them longer, the longer you leave them, they actually turn more woody. And they're actually really hard on mower blades. They dull them, like you can feel up here where it's, if it was a fresher one, it's floppy and floppy, but down in here where, you know, it's thicker and it's actually stiffer, it's almost like a wire. It's really hard on your mower blades. It really dulls them up fast. So, but spin them faster, and look at this patch of them up here too. There's a whole whack of them, you know. And they'd allow us to spray for the broad leaf stuff, it would probably have killed these, because it's a broader leaf. Well, this one especially, it's a broader leaf than just like a normal grass leaf, right? So the spray would have probably killed all these for us, but we're not allowed to spray anymore, so all you can do is pull them. Yeah, I'm gonna go pull 22 and a half acres of these. Don't think so. So we just keep mowing them. Okay, that's really all the option I got, is just to mow it. So, but at least they're green, you know. If the grass is dying off from lack of moisture, those things seem to grow on, like, I don't know what moisture they get, but nothing, and they seem to thrive on it. So as long as you can keep the sticky parts down, they don't really look too bad, but it's the sticky parts that grow up like overnight They grow like 3 inches a day, I swear. So keeps me hopping, keeping up to all them stupid things. But because actually the grass part doesn't look bad at all. It's these stupid stick weeds. So, but what can you do? Can't spray them. Can't really go and pick them all out. Holy cow, you'd be there for 3 years of Sundays in a row probably just to get them all out. And then next week they're coming up somewhere else. So, you know, funny thing was, though, it's not just me. Even up at, I think it's a shadow. Even up way up at the races there, we went through a couple of towns there and their lawns were all full of them too. So it's not just me, it's worldwide probably, or Ontario wide anyways. So anyways, I'll go do that. And when we come back, I don't know what we're going to be doing. I might be doing some more in this truck if it's not raining. I have no idea. But I've been sort of working on it after work, after hours, because, you know, I shouldn't be doing this while I'm supposed to be mowing, right? So I do all my mowing first and then, you know, whatever else, and then have some dinner and then come out usually after that. Or last night I was out late enough I had to turn my big light on here, the big light up there, to see what I was doing. It was pretty dark, but you get to that sort of dark and then the mosquitoes start, so it's like, might as well shut her down. So I think I was inside most of that time actually just doing fitting and making lines and stuff. So anyways, that's it for a few. We'll be back after some mowing and probably some lunch, and hopefully not another rainstorm, because that's just weird. But anyways, rain happens. So anyways, we shall return. Well, got some mowing done. Just after that little bit of rain there, I actually started doing a little mowing back here, and then all of a sudden it started raining. Okay, and then my wife came in just then with some lunch, so I'm like, sweet, okay. Probably gonna rain a minute and then we'll go have some lunch. Oh crap, freaking light. And so got in the car and it just poured. I'm like, sweet, I just made her. It just teamed down and you can see the ground is still a little bit wet, and this was like, well, it's almost 4 o'clock now. That was like lunchtime, so everything's sort of dried up now. But we actually gotta go over to Guelph, so I'll probably end her today. But didn't get much done, well, anything today, but that's the way she works some days. But maybe when I get home tonight, it's not super too late, I'll maybe do some more to her then, and get that other line hooked on to the box here, and then run up and then hooked on the front, so that'll be good to go. And then I can start on this rusted piece of crap here. Wouldn't mind actually seeing if I can just unloosen that fitting. Let me go grab a couple of tools and we'll give her a try just before I gotta go here. Okay, I can't remember what size they are. They might even be a 3/8 or 10 mil. I think they're a 3/8 on these ones, believe it or not. I can't really remember though. But so, can you imagine having to be underneath here, feeling up, trying to get the thing to start. Okay, so that was a 10, that didn't work. 12 would be too big. Yeah, trying to get the thing to start when you're like buried underneath this thing, laying on your back. Oh, maybe it's a 7/16. It is. So I'm so far not liking this. Oh, that's gonna need a little more work than just maybe turning her off. I might have to clip this line off of here, because what you're trying to do is spin the fitting on the line, and if the threads are sometimes a little crappy too on this thing here, it's gonna be even harder. So what I will probably have to do is chop that off of there and then put a socket on, and it should turn right off. Because I'm going to crank on this so hard that it's just going to rip this bracket apart here. I can see it flexing pretty good there. Now, I do have the technology and the tools to make a new bracket if I ever have to. But really, I don't really want to have to. Now, that seems to have loosened up a bit. So let's try the metric again here. 10's too small. Probably an 11. Which, yeah, I don't have, of course. So a 7/16 is about it. Oh, I can hear it crunching. I'm gonna have to do that when I take that apart, and hopefully it'll come apart a bit easier. once you get her loose, you're good. But anyways, that didn't work. Maybe I'll give her another spray too. Okay, sprayed her again. We'll let her sit tonight. And then, yeah, like what I'll have to do is, I'm actually curious to cut this off and see how bad it is. Maybe it's fine, but up in there, that doesn't look fine. I don't think it'd be long. She'd be out through there, so. Yeah, but anyways, for now, we shall let her sit and soak. Yeah, I still got a DRZ 400 still here if anybody's interested. It's soon gonna have a free price tag on it. No, I'm just kidding. Iron Man still didn't come for his bike, but maybe someday I'll just ride it down and then get the wife to bring me home or something. I don't know. We'll see. I know he's busy. I'm busy, but we'll see. Oh, yeah. Whoa, crap. Forgot to mention, I think I'm gonna have to maybe change my filters, hydraulic system filters, on this tractor soon. I noticed the last couple of days that if you're sitting there idling, little more than idle even, it's really jerky steering. I've noticed that before, that the filters sometimes get bunged with crap. Somehow, I don't know how it gets in there because it is a sealed unit. I don't know. And that's what happens. And if you let it go too long, it's not good for it. So I'm going to have to see what I got in stock. Ooh, I won't have enough oil, I don't think. Give her. Yeah, I'm going to have to probably go up and grab another jug of oil from the John Deere guys there, because I don't think there'll be enough. I'm going to take the bike with me for a tour or to where we're going. Should fire it up and let it warm up a minute. Oh yeah, louder than frig. Anyways, that's it for today. Hopefully when I get home, I get to work on that, I was gonna say bike, truck a bit more, and get some more lines buttoned up onto it, and then we'll have to do the big bleed. I think I'm gonna use my little vacuum sucker thing to do it, and then that's pretty much guaranteed to get all the air out. So but anyways, that's it for today. Not much else going on now. We're heading out, so we'll catch you tomorrow. I don't know. We'll do it as we do it. But anyways, if you don't mind, go vote for what baler you want to see for Saturday, Farm Sim Saturday. And we got lots of hay cut. We got some baling to do. A bit of light would be nice. There we go. Lots of baling to do. Check out that link I'm going to put in for the truck too, if what you think about that. I don't know. I'm kind of leaning to, it's getting to be a few years too old now, but yeah, I don't know. I'm about maybe 30% convinced that I should buy it. But I'm kind of thinking it's too old. A few more good years and then she'll start falling apart again, right? So I want to get something, probably 2010 would be the limit, bare limit. So, and this is an 08, I think. Now I looked underneath it and it did look fairly sprayed, like it was sprayed well with the undercover stuff, undercoating. So, they don't show you that, of course, in the picture, but, anyways, let me know. Check out those links in the bottom, and we'll catch you tomorrow. Have a good night. Thanks for watching.